need to pluck a fair rose for my love. I'd pluck a red rose blowing. Love's in my heart, a trying soul to prove. What your heart's knowing. I'd pluck a finger on a thorn. I'd pluck a finger bleeding. Red is my heart, wounded and forlorn. And your heart needing. I'd hold a finger to my tongue. I'd hold a finger waiting. My heart is sore until it's joined in song. The tide rushes in and covers footprints in the sand as my hopes erased and carried out of my hands. How the tides ebb and flow as driftwood tossed upon the shore, and my heart's cast aside and lost evermore. Yet though the ocean with waves unending covers the earth, yet is there loss after drifts from one place is with the tide to another brought, and there's naught lost beyond recall, which cannot be found if so. Found if sought. Memories like voices that call on the wind. Mevel and Quinns, whispered and tossed on the tide coming in. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Voices like songs that are heard in the dawn. Mevel and Quinns, singing the secrets of children unborn. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Dreams like the memories once born on the wind. Mevel and Quinns, lovers and children and copper and tin. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Dreams like the castles that sleep in the sand. Mevel and Quinns, slip through the fingers or held in the hand. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Songs like the dreams that the bow made and spin. Mevel and Quinns, weaving the song of the cry of the tin. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Thank you. to pluck a fair rose for my love. I to pluck a red rose blowing. Love's in my heart, a trying soul to prove. What your heart's knowing. I to pluck a finger on a thorn. I to pluck a finger bleeding. Red is my heart, a wounded and forlorn. And your heart needing. I'd hold a finger to my tongue. I'd hold a finger waiting. My heart is sore until it's joined in song.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending Vanguard Theatre's company performance of William Shakespeare's The Tempest. We respectfully ask you to turn your phones off or onto silent mode. There is no flash photography allowed as it distracts the actors. For those who desire a recording of the performance, it will be made available on YouTube at a later date. Photos of the production have also been taken and will be made available to cast members. For our photosensitive audience members, we warn that there are flashing lights used as a couple of points in the play to simulate lightning and other slight strobing effects. Please note the exits in case of emergency. If you need to use the restroom or enter the hallway during the production, please exit and reseat yourself quietly so as to not disturb the performance. Concessions will be sold during a 10-minute intermission. The show's estimated runtime is just under 2 hours. Thank you for your patronage and enjoy the show.
In the top sail, 10 to the master's whistle, blow to the lungs, boost if room enough.
Good boatswain, have care. Where's the master? Play the men.
I pray, keep below.
Where's the master, boatswain?
Do you not hear him? You might out labor. Keep your cabin. You do us this storm.
Take good, be patient.
When the sea is, hence, we'll kill these roars for the name of the king. Keep cabin, it troubles not.
Good, yet remember whom thou hast aboard.
None that I love more than myself.
I have great comfort from this fellow. He thinks he hath no drowning mark upon him.
If this were allayed them, the sky would pour down thinking pitch, dashed out the fire.
Down at the top mast. Yay! Lower! Lower! Plague upon this howling! Yet again? What do you hear? Should we cast over and drown? Have ye a mind to sink?
A talk to your throat, you bawling, blasphemous, and charitable dog!
Work you then?
Hang, you whoreson, and charitable! We are less afraid to be drowned than thou art!
Let her hold! Hold! Bring her two closest back to sea again. Let her off.
With those I saw suffer, a brave vessel who had no doubt some noble creature in her, dashed out to pieces. Oh, did the cry knock against my very heart? Poor souls, they perish. If I had been any god of power, I would have sunk in the sea within the earth or air. It should have the good ship to have swallowed and the frotting souls within her.
Be collected. No more amazement. Tell your piteous heart. There is no harm done.
Oh, woe the day.
No harm. I have done nothing but in care of thee. Of thee, my dear one, thee, my daughter, who art ignorant of what thou art, knowing not of whence I am, nor that I am more better than Prospero, master of a full poor cell, and thy no greater mother.
Mortino did never meddle in my thoughts.
'Tis time I should inform thee farther. Lend thy hand. So lie there, my heart. Wipe thou thine eyes, have comfort. The direful spectacle of the wreck which touched the very virtue of compassion in thee, I have through such provision in mine art so safely ordered that no soul, no, not so much perdition as an hair, be did to any creature in the vessel, which thou heardest cry, which thou sawest sink.
You have often begun to tell me what I am, but stopped and left me into a bootless inquisition, saying, stay, not yet.
The hour is now come. The very minute bids thee ope thine ear. Obey and be attentive. Canst thou remember a time before we came unto this cell? I do not think thou canst, for thou wast not out 3 years old.
But certainly, ma'am, I can.
By what? By some other house or person? Of anything the image tell me that hath kept with thy remembrance.
'Tis far off, rather like a dream than an assurance that my remembrance warrants. But had I not 4 or 5 women that once attended me?
Thou hadst and more, Miranda. But how is it that this lives in thy mind? What seest thou else in the dark, backward, and abysm of time? If thou rememberest aught ere thou camest here, how thou camest here thou mayest.
But that I do not.
12 years since, Miranda, 12 years since, thy mother was the Duchess of Milan and a lady of power.
Ma'am, aren't you my mother?
Thy mother was a piece of virtue, and thy mother was the Duchess of Milan, and thou her heir and princess, no worse issued.
Oh, heavens, what foul play that we came from hence, or blessed what we did.
Both, my girl. By foul play, as thou sayest, were we heaved thence, but blessedly hope hither.
Oh, my heart bleeds to think that I deem that I've turned you to please you farther.
My sister and thy aunt, called Antonia. I pray thee, mark me, that a sister should be so perfidious. She, whom next to thyself of all the world I loved, and to her put the manage of my estate, as at that time through all the signories it was the first, and Prospero, the prime duchess, being thus reputed in dignity, and for the liberal arts without a parallel. Those being all my study, the government I cast upon my sister, and to my state grew stranger, being transported and wrapped in secret studies. Thy false aunt, dost thou attend me?
Ma'am, most heedful.
I, thus neglecting worldly ends, all dedicated to the closeness and the bettering of my mind, with that which, but by being so retired, overprized all popular rates. My trust, like a good parent, I did beget of her. A falsehood, in its contrary, as great as my trust was, which had indeed no limit. A confidence, sans bound. She being thus lorded, to credit her own lie, she did believe she was indeed the Duchess. Out of the substitution in executing the outward face of royalty with all prerogative. Hence, her ambition growing. Dost thou hear?
Your tale, ma'am, would cure deafness.
To have no screen between the part she played and her she played it for, she needs will be absolute Milan. Me, poor lady, my library was dukedom large enough. Of temporal royalties, she thinks me now incapable. Confederates, so dry she was for sway, with the Queen of Naples, to give her annual tribute, do her homage. The Queen of Naples, being an enemy to me inveterate, hearkens my sister's suit, which was that she, in lieu of the premises of homage, and I know not how much tribute, should extirpate me and mine out of the dukedom, and confer fair Milan with all its honors on my sister, whereon a treacherous army levied. One midnight, fated to the purpose, did Antonia open the gates of Milan, and the ministers, fated to the purpose, hurried thence, me and thy crying self.
Oh, I not remembering how I cried out, then we'll cry it over again. It rings my eye to it. Wherefore did the hour destroy us?
Well demanded, wench. My tale provokes that question. Dear, they durst not. So dear the love my people bore me, nor set a mark so bloody on the business, with colors fairer painted their foul ends. In few, they hurried us, aboard a bark, bore us some leagues to sea, where they had prepared a rotten carcass of a boat, not rigged nor tackle, sail nor mast, the very rats instinctively had quit it. There they hoist us to cry to the sea that roared to us, to sigh to the wind whose pity, sighing back again, did us but loving wrong.
Alack, what trouble was I then to you?
Oh, a cherubim, thou wast that did preserve me. Thou didst smile, infused with a fortitude from heaven. When I have decked the sea with drops full salt, and under my burthen groaned, which raised in me an undergoing stomach to bear against that which should ensue.
How we came ashore.
By providence divine, some food we had and some fresh water, that a noble Neapolitan, Gonzala, out of her charity, being then appointed master of this design, did give us. Rich garments, linens, stuffs, and necessaries, which have since steaded much. Out of her goodness, knowing I loved my books, she did furnish me from mine own library with volumes that I prize above my dukedom.
Might I but ever see that woman?
Now I arise. Sit still and hear the last of our sea sorrow. Here on this island we arrived, and here have I, thy schoolmaster, made thee more profit than other princesses, who have time for vainer hours and tutors not so careful.
Thank you, heavens for all, and now I pray you, ma'am, for still 'tis beating my mind your reason for raising the sea storm.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant, come. I am ready now. Approach my Ariel, come.
Well, hail, great master. I've come to answer thy best pleasure. Be to fly, to swim, to dive into the fire, to ride on the curled clouds. Ariel, in all its quality.
Hast thou, spirit, performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
To every article. I boarded the king's ship, now in the beak, now in the waist, in the deck, in every cabin, of sulfurous roaring and most mighty Neptune, seen to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. Oh, yea, his dread trident shake.
My brave spirit!
All but mariners plunge into the foaming brine. Then all afire with me, the king's son Ferdinand, with hair then upstaring like reeds, not hair, was the first to cry out,
Hell is empty, and all of the devils are here!
In troops I've dispersed them about the isle. The king's son Ferdinand I have landed by himself, at an odd angle the isle of sitting, and his arms in a sad knot.
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed. There's more work.
Is there more toil? Since thou dost give me pains, let me remember what thou hast promised, which is not yet performed me.
How now? Moody? What is thou canst demand?
My liberty!
Before the time be out, no more!
I pray thee, I have told thee no lies, made thee no mistakings, served without grudge or grumbling. Thou didst promise to make me a full year.
Dost thou forget from what a torment I did free thee?
No.
Thou liest, malignant thing. Hast thou forgotten the foul witch, Sycorax, who with age and envy was grown into a hoop?
No, ma'am.
Thou hast. Where is she born? Speak.
Ma'am, in Algier.
Oh, was she so? This foul witch, Sycorax, who, for mischiefs manifold and sorceries terrible, to enter human hearing from Algier, thou knowest, was banished. For one thing she did, they would not take her life. This blue-eyed hag was hither brought with child. Thou, as thou reportest thyself, wast then her servant. And thou, a spirit too delicate to act her earthy, and of hoard commands, refusing her grand hests, she did confine thee, with the help of her more potent ministers and her most unmitigable rage, into a cloven pine, within which rift thou didst painfully remain a dozen years, within which space she died, and left thee there to vent thy groans as fast as mill wheels strike. Then was this island, save for the sun, the sheeted litter here, a freckled whelp, hag-born, not honored with a human shape.
Yes, her son, Caliban.
Dull thing I say so, he that Caliban, whom I now keep in service. Thou best knowest what a torment I did find thee in. Thy groans did make wolves howl, and did penetrate the breast of ever angry bears. It was a torment laid upon the damned, which Sycorax could not again undo. Therefore, it was by mine art, when I arrived and heard thee, that made gape the pine and let thee out.
I thank thee, master.
If thou more murmurest, I shall rend an oak and peg thee in his knotty entrails, till thou hast howled away 12 winters.
Pardon, master. I will be correspondent to command and do my spiriting gently.
Do so, and after 2 days, I will discharge thee.
That's my noble master. Say, what shall I do? What shall I do?
Go. Make thyself like a nymph of the sea. Be subject to no sight but thine and mine, invisible to every eyeball else. Go, take this shape. Hitherto int. Go, hence with diligence.
Master, it shall be done.
Awake, dear heart, awake. Thou hast slept well. Awake.
The strangest of your story put heaviness into me.
Shake it off. Come on, we will visit Caliban, my slave.
'Tis a villain, Mom, I do not love to look on.
But as 'tis, we cannot miss him. He does make our fire, fetch in our wood, and serve in offices that profit us. What ho, slave, Caliban, thou earth thou, speak!
There's wood enough within!
Come forth, I say, there's other business for thee. Come, thou tortoise, win! Thou most poisonous slave, got by the devil himself, upon thy wicked dam, come forth!
As wicked you as e'er my mother brushed, with raven's feather from unwholesome fen, drop on you both a southwest blow on ye, and blister you all over!
For this, be sure, tonight thou shalt have crew! Sight shall pen thy breath up! Urchins shall, for that vast of night, work all exercise on thee! Thou shalt be pinched, as thick as honeycomb, each pinch more stinging than bees that made them.
I must eat my dinner. This island's mine, by Sycorax, my mother, which thou takest from me when thou camest first. Thou strokest me and madest much of me. Wouldst give me water with berries in it, and teach me how to name the bigger light, and how the less that burn by day and night. And then I loved thee, and showed thee all the qualities of the isle, fresh springs, brine pits, barren place and fertile. Curse me, I that did so! All the charms of Sycorax, toads, beetles, bats light on you! For I am all the subjects that you have, which first was mine own king. And here you stymie in this hard rock, whilst you do keep from me the rest of the island.
Thou most lying slave, I have used thee, filth as thou art, with human care, and launched thee in mine own cell. Till thou, to seek to violate the honor of my child.
Oh-ho! Oh-ho, what has happened to you? Thou didst prevent me, I had people to else this isle with Calibans!
Abhorred slave, I pity thee! Took pains to make thee speak! Taught thee each hour one thing or other, till thou didst not savage! Know thine own meaning, but wouldst gabble like a thing most brutish. I endowed thy purposes with words that made them known. Therefore, wast thou deservedly confined into this rock that hath deserved more than a prison.
You taught me language, and my profit on it is I know how to curse. The Red Plague rid you for learning me your language!
Hagseed, hence! If thou neglectest, or dost unwillingly what I command, I'll rack thee with old crows, and all thy bones with aches, make thee roar that we shall tremble at thy din.
No, pray thee. I must obey, for her art is of such power, it would control my dam's god, Setebos, and make a vassal of him.
So slave hence!
Where should this music be? Aye, the air or the earth? It sounds no more, but sure, it waits upon some god of the island somewhere. Sitting on a bank, weeping again, the queen, my mother's wrecked. This music crept by me upon the waters, allaying both my fury and its passion with its sweet air. Thence it hath followed me here, or it hath drawn me rather. But 'tis gone.
Four fathom five. Four fathom five thy mother lies. Of her bones are coral made. Those are pearls that were her eyes. Nothing of her that doth fade, but doth suffer a sea change into something rich and strange. Sea nymphs hourly ring her knell. Hark, now I hear them ding dong bell.
The ditty does remember my drowned mother. This is no mortal business, nor no sound that the earth owes. I hear it now, above me.
The fringed curtain of thine eye advance, and say what thou seest yond.
What, 'tis a spirit. Lord, how it looks about. Believe me, Mom, it carries a brave form, but 'tis a spirit.
No, wench, it eats and sleeps, and hath such senses as we have such. This gallant which thou seest wast in the wreck, and... but he's something stained with grief, that's beauty's canker. Thou mightest call him a goodly person. He hath lost his fellows and strays about to find them.
I might call him a thing divine, for nothing natural I've ever saw so noble.
It goes on, I see as my soul prompts it. Spirit, fine spirit, I'll free thee within 2 days for this.
Oh, most sure, upon the god upon this isle, play, bid my prayers and... may I know how I may bear me here, and, well, my prime request, which I do last pronounce, is, oh, you wonder, if you be maid or no.
No wonder, sir, but certainly a maid.
My language, heavens, I'm the best of them that speak this speech.
How? The best? What wert thou the Queen of Naples heard thee?
A single thing as I am now, that wonders to hear thy speak of Naples. She does
hear me, and as she does, I weep him Naples, who hath with my own eyes hath never sought at ebb. Behold, the queen, my mother's wrecked.
Oh, lack for mercy.
Yes, faith in all her lords, the Duchess of Milan and her brave son being twain.
The Duchess of Milan and her more braver daughter could control thee if now 'twere fit to do it. At the first sight, they have changed eyes. Delicate Ariel, I'll set thee free for this. A word, good sir. I fear you have done yourself some wrong. A word.
Why speaks my mother so ungently? This is the second man I saw, and the first I've ever sighed for. Pity move my mother to be inclined my way.
I'll make you the Queen of Naples.
Soft, sir, one word more. They are both in either's powers, but this swift business I must uneasy make, lest too light winning make the prize light. One word more I charge thee. Thou here attend me. Thou dost here usurp a name which thou owest not, and hast put thyself on this island as a spy to win it from me, the lady on it.
No, as I am a man.
There's nothing ill in such a temple if an ill spirit so fair house good things and strive and dwell with it.
Follow me.
But,
speak not you for him. He's a traitor. Come. I'll manacle thy neck and feet together. Seawater shalt thou drink. Thy food shall be the fresh brook mussels, withered roots and husks, wherein the acorn cradled. Follow.
No, I will resist such entertainment. Till mine enemy has more power.
Mother, make too not rash a trial of him. He is gentle and not fearful.
What, I say? My foot, my tutor? Put thy sword up, traitor, who makest a show but darest not strike. Thy conscience is so possessed with guilt, come from thy lord, that I can here disarm thee with this stick and make thy weapon drop.
Beseech you, mother.
Hence, hang not on my garments.
I'll be his surety.
Silence. One word more shall make me chide thee, if not hate thee. What? An advocate for an impostor? Hush! Thou thinkest there are no more such shapes as he, having seen but him and Caliban, foolish wench! To most of men, this is a Caliban, and they to him are angels.
Then my affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man.
Come on, obey! Thy nerves are in their infancy again, and hath no vigor in them.
I see, they are. My spirits are all bound up as if in a dream. The loss of my mother, the weakness which I feel, the loss of all of my friends, and this woman's threats are but light to me. Might I but through my prison once a day behold this maid, all corners else of the earth? Am I really in such a prison?
It works. Come on. Thou hast done well, fine Ariel. Follow me. Hark what else thou shalt do me.
Be of comfort. My mother's of better nature than she is by speech. This unwanted which now came from it.
Thou shalt be free as mountain winds, but do exactly all points of my command.
To the syllable.
Come,
but
follow. Speak not you for him.
Teach you, ma'am, be merry. You have cause, so have we all, of joy, for our escape is far beyond our loss.
Prithee, peace.
She receives comfort like cold porridge.
The visitor will not give him oversell.
Look, she's winding the watch of her wit.
By and by it will strike.
Ma'am?
She will be talking, the old cock.
When every grief is entertained, that's offered, comes to the entertainer.
A dollar!
The lore comes to him indeed. You've spoken truer than you purposed.
You have taken it wiselier than I meant you should.
Therefore, my lady.
Fie, what a spendthrift she is of her tongue.
I prithee, spare!
Well, I've done, but yet. Though this island seem desert, here is everything advantageous to life.
True. Save means to live.
Of that there is none or little.
Look how lush and lusty the grass looks. How green.
The ground indeed looks, tawny.
With an eye of green in it.
She misses not much.
No, she doth but mistake the truth totally.
But the rarity of it is, being indeed almost beyond credit.
As many vouched rarities are.
That our garments, being, as they were, drenched in the sea, hold notwithstanding their freshness and glosses. Being rather new dyed than drenched in salt water.
Her word
me
is more.
Methinks our garments are now as fresh as when we first put them on in Afric, at the marriage of the queen's fair daughter Clarabel to the king of Tunis.
Her word is more the miraculous harp. She hath raised the wall and houses too.
What impossible matter will she make easy next?
I think she will carry this island home in her pocket and give it her son for an apple.
And, sowing the kernels of it in the sea, bring forth more islands.
Aye.
Why, in good time.
Ma'am, we were just speaking that our garments seem now as fresh as the first day we wore them at the marriage of your daughter, who is now queen. Is not, ma'am, my doublet as fresh as the first day I wore it? I mean, in a sort.
That sort was well fished for.
When I wore it at your daughter's marriage?
You cram these words into mine ears against the stomach of my sense. Would I have never married my daughter there, for coming thence my son is lost. And in my rate, she too, who is so far from Italy removed, I ne'er again shall see her. Oh, mine heir of Naples and of Milan, what strange fish hath made his meal on thee.
Ma'am, he may live. I saw him beat the surges under him and ride upon their back. He trod the water whose enmity he flung aside and breasted the surges most swollen beneath him. His bold head above the contentious wave he kept, and with his good arms and lusty stroke he'd oared himself to shore. His wave-worn bases bowed to relieve him. I not doubt he came alive to land.
No. No, he's gone.
Ma'am, you may thank yourself for this great loss, though not bless our Europe with your daughter, but rather lose her to an African, where she at least is banished from your eye, who hath cause to whet the grief on it.
So is pretty. Peace.
You were kneeled to and importuned otherwise by all of us. The fair soul herself weighed between loathness and obedience, so which the end of the beam should bow. We have lost your son, I fear forever. Milan and Naples have more widows in them in this business is making than we bring back men to comfort them, and the fault is your own.
So is the dearest of the lost.
My lord Sebastian, the truth you speak doth lack some gentleness and time to speak it in. You rub the sore when you should bring the plaster.
Very well.
It is foul weather and it's all good, ma'am, when you are cloudy.
Prithee, no more. Thou dost talk nothing to me.
I do well believe, your highness. I did it to minister occasion to these gentlemen, who are such sensible and nimble lungs as always used to laugh at nothing.
T'was you we laugh at.
Who in this kind of merry fooling am nothing to you, so you may continue to laugh at nothing still.
What a blow was there given.
We would so, and then go a bat fouling.
Nay, good lord, be not angry.
No, I warrant you, I would not adventure my discretion so weakly. Will you laugh me asleep? For I'm very heavy.
Go sleep, and hear us.
What? So soon asleep? I wish my thoughts would, with mine eyes, shut themselves up. I find they are inclined to do so.
Pray you, ma'am, do not emit the heavy offer of it. It seldom visits sorrow, when it doth it as a comforter.
We too will watch over your person while you take your rest, and watch for your safety.
Thank you. Wondrous heavy!
What a strange drowsiness possesses them.
It is the quality of the climate.
Why doth an eyelid sink? I find not myself disposed to sleep.
Nor I. My spirits are nimble. They fell together all, as by consent. They dropped, as by a thunderstroke. What might, worthy Sebastian? Oh, what might? No more. And yet, methinks I see it in thy face, what thou shouldst be. the occasion speaks thee. In my strong imagination, sees a crown dropped upon thy head.
What art thou waking?
Do you not hear me speak?
I do, and surely it is a sleepy language, and thou speakest out of thy sleep. What did thou just say?
Noble Sebastian, thou lets thy fortune sleep. Die, rather. Winks while thou art waking.
You dost snore distinctly. There's meaning in thy snores.
I am more serious than my custom. You must be so too, if heed me. Oh, if you but knew how you the purpose cherish, while thus you mock it. How, in stripping it, you more invest it.
Prithee, say on. The setting of thine eye and cheek proclaim a matter from thee, and a birth indeed, which throws thee much to yield.
Thus, although this lady of weak resemblance, this who shall be of as little memory when she is earthed, hath here almost persuade the queen her son's alive, 'tis as impossible that he is undrowned as she that sleeps here swims.
I have no hope that he's undrowned.
Oh, out of that, no hope. What great hope have you? No hope that way is another way, so high a hope that not even ambition can pierce a wink beyond, but doubt discovery there. Will you grant with me, then, that Ferdinand is drowned?
He's gone.
Then, tell me, who's the next heir of Naples?
Clarabelle!
Is she that is queen of Tunis? She that dwells 10 leagues beyond man's life? She that, from Naples, can have no note, unless the sun were post, the man in the moon too slow, till newborn chains be rough and reasonable. She that for whom? We all were sea-swallowed, though some of us cast again, and by that destiny to perform an act whereof its past is prologue, what comes in your and my discharge.
What stuff is this? How say you? 'Tis true my sister's daughter is queen of Tunis. So is she heir of Naples. Twixt the regions there is some space.
A space whose every cubit seems to cry out, how shall that Clarabelle measure us back in Naples? Keep in Tunis, and let Sebastian wake. Say, this were death that hath seized them. Why, they be no worse than now there are. There be that can rule Naples as well as she that sleeps. Lords prate as amply and unnecessarily as this Gonzala. I myself can make a better chow of his deep chat. Though that you bore the mind that I do. What sleep were this for your advancement? Do you not hear me?
Methinks I do.
And how does your content tender your good fortune?
I do remember you did supplant your brother Prospero.
True. And look at how well my garment sits upon me. Much fitter than before. My brother's servants were once my fellows. Now they are my men.
But for your conscience.
Aye. Where lies that? If 'twere a kibe, 'twould put me in my slipper. But I feel not this deity in my bosom. 20 consciences stand twixt me and Milan. Candied be they, and melt ere they molest. Here lies your sister, no better than the earth she lies upon. If she were now that which she's like, that's dead. Whom I, with this obedient steel, 3 inches of it, can lay to bed forever.
Thy case, dear friend, shall be my precedent, as thou gotst Milan. I'll come by Naples, draw thy sword. 1 stroke shall free thee from the tribute which thou payest, and I, the king, shall love thee.
Draw thy weapon, and when I rear my hand, do you the like, to fall it on Gonzalva.
Oh, but 1 word.
My master through her art perceives the danger that you, her friend, are in, and sends me forth or else her project fails to keep them living. Will you hear to snore and lie, open-eyed conspiracy her time doth take? If of life you can take care, wake up, beware, awake, awake!
Then let us be sudden.
What is the matter?
Why are you drawn? Why was this ghastly looking?
Whilst we stood here securing your repose, even now we heard a hollow bellowing of bulls, or rather lions. Ah! Did not wake you. It struck mine ear most terribly.
I heard nothing.
Oh, 'twas a din to fright a monster's ear, to make an earthquake. Nay, it was a whole herd of lions.
Heard you this, Gonzala?
Upon mine honor, ma'am, there was a humming, a strange one too, that did wake me. I cried as mine eyes opened, and I saw their weapons drawn. There was a noise, 'tis verily. 'Tis best we stand upon our guard, or that we leave this place. Let's draw our weapons.
Lead off this ground, and let's make further search for my poor son.
Heavens keep him from these beasts, for he's sure in the island.
Lead away.
all the infections that the sun sucks up. From bogs, fens, flats, on Prosper Fall, and make her, by inchmeal, a disease. Her spirits hear me, and yet I needs must curse, but they'll not pinch me, frighten me with urchin shows, pitch me in the mire, nor lead me like a firebrand in the dark out of my way, unless she bid them, for every trifle are they set upon me, sometime like apes that mow and shatter at me, and after bite me, then, like hedgehogs, who mount their pricks at my footfall, sometime am I all wound with adders, who with cloven tongues do hiss me into madness. Lo now, lo, here comes a spirit of hers, and to torment me for bringing wood in slowly. I'll fall flat. Perchance, he will not mind me.
Oh, he is neither bush nor shrub to bear up any weather at all. And another storm brewing, I hear it sing in the wind. Prithee, what is thy name? You in the front row, what is your name? Josh, may I hide with you? My mother told me never to hide with someone so eager. Yon same cloud cannot choose but to fall by pailfuls.
What have we here? Is it a man or a fish? Dead or alive?
Oh,
a fish. It smells like a fish. A very ancient and fish-like smell. Oh, I'm not the newest poor John.
A strange fish. Were I in England now, as I once was, and had but this fish painted, not a holiday fool there would give but a piece of silver. There would this monster make a man.
Any fool there makes a man.
Legged like a man. And fins like arms. Warm, oh my troth, I do now let loose my opinion, hold it no longer. This is no fish. But an islander that hath lately suffered from a thunderbolt. Alas, the storm is come again. My best way is to hide under this man's gabardine. There is no other shelter hereabouts. Misery acquaints a man with strange bedfellows. I will here shroud till the dregs of the storm be past.
Shall I to sea? Here is where I die ashore. This is a scurvy tune to sing at a man's funeral. But here's my comfort. The master, the swabber, the bosun and I, the gunner and his mate, loved Moll, Meg, Marion, and Marjorie. But none of us cared for Kate, for she had a tongue with a tang, would cry to a sailor, go hang. Then, to sea boys, let her go hang. This is a scurvy tune, too. Oh well, here's my comfort.
Do not torment me! Oh!
What's the matter? Have we devils here? Do we put tricks upon with savages and men of end? Aha! I have not escaped drowning to be afeared now of your four legs. Fort Hathman said, as proper a man's ever went, on four legs, cannot make him give ground. And it shall be said so again, while Stefano breathes at nostrils.
The spirit torments me, oh!
This is some monster of the isle now with four legs, who hath got, as I take it, an ague. Where the devil should he learn our language? I shall give him some relief, if it be but for that. If I can recover him, and keep him tame, and get to Naples with him, he shall make for a present for any emperor who trod on neat's leather.
Do not torment me, I pray thee, or bring my wood in faster.
He's in his fit now, and won't speak after the wisest. He shall taste of my bottle. If he have never drunk wine afore, we'll go near to remove his fit. If I can recover him and keep him tame, I will not take much of him. He shall pay for him that hath him in that soundly.
Shh, 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 shh. Thou wilt anon, I know by thy trembling. Now prosper works in thee.
Come on your ways and open your mouth. This is that which will give language to you, cat. Aha! Now, open your mouth. This will shake your shaking. I can tell you when that soundly. You cannot tell us who's your friend.
I should know that voice. But he is drowned, and there are devils here. Oh, defend me!
Four legs, and two voices. A most delicate monster indeed. His forward voice is to speak well of his friends. His backward voice is to utter foul speeches and to detract. If all of the wine in my bottle shall recover him, I shall help his ague. Amen. Come, I shall pour some into thy other mouth.
Stefano?
Doth thy other mouth call me? Mercy, mercy, this is a devil and no monster. I shall leave him. I have no long spoon.
No, if thou beest Stefano, touch me and speak to me. For it is I, Trinculo. Be not afeard, thy good friend, Trinculo.
Well, if thou beest Trinculo, come forth. Here, I shall pull thee by the lesser legs. If any be Trinculo's legs, these are they. Ugh. Whew.
Oh.
Well, thou art very Trinculo indeed.
Stefano!
Trinculo! Wait a minute. How comest thou be the siege of this moon calf? Can he vent Trinculos?
I took him to be killed with a thunderstroke. But art thou no drowned, Stefano? And art thou living, Stefano? Is the storm overblown? I hear the dead moon calf's gabardine for fear of the storm. Oh, and thou art living, Stefano. Oh, Stefano, too many a bullet escaped.
Breathing, do not turn me about. My stomach is not constant.
These be fine things. And if they be not sprites, that's a brave god that bears celestial liquor. I will kneel to him.
Come, Trinculo, tell me how thou escapest. How comest hither? Swear by this bottle how comest hither. I escaped but of sack, which the sailors heaved o'erboard.
swear by this bottle, which was made from the bark of a tree by mine own hand since I was cast ashore.
I'll swear by that bottle, to be thy true subject, for the liquor is not earthly.
Is he with you?
I thought he was with you.
Oh. Come, swear to that how thou escapest.
Swim ashore, man, like a duck. I can swim like a duck, I'll be sworn.
Oh, come, kiss the book. Though thou canst swim like a duck, thou art made like a goose.
Oh, Stefano, hast thou any more of this?
No, but, man!
Yeah!
My cellar is hid in a rock by the seaside where my wine is hid. How now, mooncalf? How does thine ague?
Hast thou not dropped from heaven?
Out o' the moon, I do assure thee. I was the man I was in the moon, when time was.
I have seen thee in her, and I have loved thee. My mistress showed me thee, and thy dog, and thy bush!
Well then, come, kiss the book. I shall furnish it anon with new content swear.
By this good light, this is a very shallow monster. I have feared of him. A very weak monster. The man in the moon. Oh, poor credulous monster. Well drawn, monster, in good sooth.
I'll show thee every fertile inch of the isle, and I'll kiss thy foot! Pray you, be my god.
By this light, a most perfidious and drunken monster. When God's asleep, he'll rob his bottle.
I'll kiss thy foot. I'll swear myself thy true subject.
I shall laugh myself to death at this puppy-headed monster. A most scurvy monster. I could find it in my heart to beat him.
Come, down and swear. Come kiss.
But the poor monster's in drink, an abominable monster.
I'll show thee the best springs. I'll pluck thee berries. I'll fish for thee and get thee wood enough.
A most ridiculous monster. To make a wonder of a poor drunkard.
Plague upon the tyrant that I serve! I'll bear no more sticks for her, but serve thee, thou wondrous man. Come, come, let me take thee to where the crabs grow, and I, with my long nails, will dig thee pig nuts, show thee a jay's nest, and instruct thee on how to snare the nimble marmoset. I'll show thee clustering filberts. And sometime, I'll get the young scammels from the rock. Wilt thou go with me?
Prithee now, lead the way, without any more talking. Trinculo, the king and our company, else being drowned, we shall inherit here. Here, bear my bottle, fellow Trinculo. We shall fill him by and by again.
Farewell, master! Farewell! Farewell!
A howling monster, a drunken monster.
No more dams I'll make for fish, nor fetch in firing at requiring, nor scrape trencher, nor wash dish. Ban, ban, Caliban, as a new master get a new man. Freedom, heyday, freedom, heyday, freedom!
Oh, brave monster, lead the way!
This, my mean task, would
be as heavy to me as odious. But the mistress which I serve quickens what's dead and makes my labors pleasures. Oh, she is 10 times more gentle than her mother, and she is composed of harshness. I must remove several of these logs and pile them up upon a sore injunction. My mistress weeps when she sees me work and says such baseness had never like executor. I forget, but these sweet thoughts even do refresh my labors and, oh, busy less when I do it.
Alas, pray you now not work so hard. I would have lightning had burnt up those logs that you were enjoined to pile. Pray set it down, rest yourself. My mother is hard at study. Pray rest yourself. She is safe for these 3 hours.
Oh, dear mistress, the sun will set before I shall discharge what I must do.
It would become me as well does you. I should do it with much more ease, for my goodwill is to it, and yours is against.
Poor worm, thou art infected. This visitation shows it.
You look wearily.
No, noble mistress. 'Tis fresh morning with me when you are by at night. Oh, I do beseech you that I might have said it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, mother, I broke your hest to say so.
Admired Miranda. Indeed, the most top of admiration. Worth many a lady that I have eyed with best regard. For several virtues have I liked several women. Never any so fun soul. But some did defect, in her did quarrel, and with the noblest grace she owed, put it to the foil. And, man, Moran, oh precious creature.
I do not know one of my sex, no woman's face remembered, save for my glass besides my mother's and my own. Nor that I may call men than you a good friend. How features are abroad, I am skillness of. But by my modesty, a jewel in my dower, I wish not any company in the world but you. Nor can imagination form a shape besides itself. I prattle something too wildly. My mother's precepts I therefore do forget.
I am in my condition a prince, Miranda. I do think a king I would not so, and would no more endure this wooden slavery than to suffer the flesh fly blow my mouth. Hear my soul speak. The very instant that I saw you did my heart fly to your service. And there it resides, and I, this patient logman.
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to the sound and crown. But I profess, Miranda, I do love, prize, honor you.
I am a fool to weep of what I'm glad of.
Fair encounter of two most rare affections. Heavens rain grace on that which breeds between them.
Wherefore weep you?
At mine unworthiness, I dare not offer what I shall desire to give, much less take what I die to want. But this thrifling and all the more it seeks to hide itself. The bigger bulk shows, hence bashful cunning. I am your wife if you'll marry me. If not, I'll die your maid. To be your fellow, you may deny me, but I'll be your servant whether you will or no.
Miranda, and I thus humble ever.
My husband, then?
Yes, with the heart as willing as freedom heir into bondage. Here is my hand.
And mine in it, till half an hour hence.
1,000,000. Oh.
should have had her do it.
So glad of this as they, I cannot be, who are surprised with all my rejoicing at nothing can be more. I'll to my book, for yet ere supper time must I perform much business appertaining.
What do you do with a drunken sailor?
What do you do with a drunken sailor?
What do you do with a drunken sailor?
Early in the morning.
Way,
hey, and up she raises.
Way, hey, and up she raises.
Way, hey, and up she raises.
Early in the morning.
Tell not me. When the butt is out, we shall drink water. And not a drop before. Therefore, bear up in boredom. Servant monster, drink to me.
Servant monster, the folly of this island. They say there are but five upon this isle. We are three. If the other two be brained like unto us, the state totters.
Drink, servant monster, when I bid thee. Thy eyes are almost set in thy head.
Where should they be set else? He were a brave monster indeed if they were set in this tail.
My man monster hath drowned his tug and sack. My part, the sea cannot drown me. I swam, ere I could recover the shore. 55 leagues, off and on. By this light, thou shalt be my lieutenant, my monster, oh, my standard.
Your lieutenant, if you list. He's in no shape to be a standard.
Will not run, mon is your monster.
Nor go neither, but lie like dogs and say nothing neither.
Speak, moon calf, once in thy life, if thou be'st a good moon calf.
Oh, how does thy honor? I'll lick thy shoe. I'll not serve him. He's not valiant.
Why, thou liest most ignorant monster. I am in case to justle a constable. Was there ever man a coward who drunk so much sack as I today? And wilt thou tell a monstrous lie, being but half fish and half monster? Boo.
Oh, how he mocks me! Wilt thou let him, my lord?
Oh, lord, quoth he, the monstrous should be such a natural.
Low, low again! Bite him to death, I prithee!
Trinculo! If you trouble him any more in his tail, then by this sand I shall supplant some of your teeth.
I thank my noble lord. Wilt thou hearken once again to the suit I made to thee?
Marry, will I. Kneel and repeat it. I shall stand, and so shall Trinculo.
As I told thee before, I am subject to a tyrant, a sorceress, who by her cunning hath cheated me of the isle.
Thou liest!
Thou jesting monkey! I would my valiant master would destroy thee! I do not lie!
Trinculo! If you trouble him any more in tail, then by this hand I shall turn my mercy out o' doors and make a stockfish of thee.
Why, I said nothing.
Come then, and no more. Proceed.
I say, by sorcery she got it. From me she got it. If thou wilt revenge it upon her, for I know thou darest. But this thing dare not!
That's most certain. How now will it be compassed? Canst thou bring me to the party?
I shall yield her to thee asleep, where thou mayst knock a nail into her bead.
Thou liest, thou canst not!
What a pie ninny is this! Thou scurvy patch! I do beseech my master, give him blows, and take his bottle from him! For when that's gone, he'll drink none but brine, for I'll not show him where the quick freshes are.
Trinculo, you trouble him any more in's tail, then by this hand, like I said, I shall supplant some of your teeth.
Why? What did I? I did nothing. I'll go farther off.
Didst thou not say he lied?
Thou liest.
Do I so? Take thou that. As you like it, give me the lie another time.
I did not give the lie. Out of your wits and bearing too, a pox o' your bottle. This can sack and drinking do. A murrain on your monster, and the devil take your fingers.
Prithee, stand farther off.
Beat him enough. Give it time, and I'll beat him too.
Trinculo, stand farther.
Can I sit here? Okay. So, how are you liking the show? I'm your favorite character, right? Thank you. Way better than Stefano. Hey, Stefano, this is good, right?
Nay, stand farther.
Why is he talking to the shrubbery?
He is a fool.
Stefano, there are a lot of shrubs on this island.
'Tis a very shrubby land indeed.
Yes.
Hey, Trinculo. Come here often?
Is this what you call sliding into the
So, demands? I'm basically king of this island.
I believe so.
Is he good at it?
No. Trinculo, for the sake of thy neighbor, stand farther off.
But Stefano, this one was hot.
No.
Your love's labor's lost.
Stefano, any farther and I'll be in the moon.
Then go to the moon. The keys are under the carpet. Come, proceed.
As I told thee before, 'tis a custom with
Stefano, Stefano, I found the man in the moon.
What?
That's not the man in the moon. He's the man in the moon. He told me.
Then who's this?
That's clearly the dog. Look at all the hair.
Rude, but okay, fair. And who's this?
That's the bush.
Okay. Okay, then who is this?
Oh, my mistress told me of him. It's Cousin Larry, who lives on the dark side of the moon. He must have taken your spot in your absence.
Would you like me to remove him for you, Stefano?
No, I'll take care of it when I get home.
Cool.
Come, proceed.
Thou art most merciful. As I told thee before, it is a custom with her in the afternoon to sleep there. Thou mayest brain her, having first seized her books, or with a log, batter her skull, or punch her with a stake, or cut her wizened with thy knife, having first seized her books, for without them she's but a sot, as am I, and hath not one spirit to command. They all do hate her as rootedly as I. Burn her books. She has brave utensils, or so she calls them.
Stefano, that's a knife and a fork.
I know.
Okay, yep, cool.
But that most deeply to consider is the beauty of her daughter. She herself calls her, pardon my French, a nonpareille. Your French is beautiful.
Are thou speaking in tongues, Stefano?
I myself never saw a woman, but Prospero, Sycorax, my dam, and she. But she as far surpasseth the others, as greatest does least.
Is it so brave, alas?
Aye, my lord, she will be thy queen, and she will bear thee brave brood.
Monster, I shall kill this woman. Her daughter and I shall become king and queen. Save our graces. Trinculo and thyself shall become viceroys. Dost thou like the plot, Trinculo?
What?
I say, dost thou like the plot, Trinculo?
Excellent.
Excellent. Come, give me thy hand. I'm sorry that I beat thee, but where thou still livest, keep a good tongue in thy head.
I will.
Of course you will.
Oh, thou makest me merry! Let us be jocund! Wilt thou troll the catch thou taughtest me but while ere?
Aye, on mine honor. I shall do reason, any reason. Come, Trinculo, let us sing! Floutum and scoutum and scoutum and floutum, that is free.
We are living. That's not the tune.
But what is the tune?
Yours, obviously.
All right, Trinculo, repeat after me. Floutum.
Ah!
Oh! Ah! Ah! Ah!
This is the tune of our catch, played by the picture of nobody.
If thou be'st a man, show thyself in thy likeness. If thou be'st the devil, take as thou list.
Oh, forgive me my sins.
All men that die pays all debts. I defy thee. Mercy upon us.
Art thou afeard?
No, monster, not high.
Be not afeard. The isle is full of noises, sounds, and sweet airs that delight and hurt not. Sometime, a thousand twangling instruments will hum about mine ears, and voices, who, after a long sleep, will make me sleep again. And in my dreams, methought, the clouds would open and shower treasures upon me, that, when I waked, I cried to dream again.
This shall prove a brave kingdom, where I shall have my music but for nothing.
When Prospero is destroyed.
That shall be by. And by. I heard the story.
The sound is going away. Let's follow it and after do our work.
Lead, monster, will follow. I would I could see this tabor. He lays it on.
Oh, wilt come. I'll follow. Stefano!
We will now have a short intermission. It will be 10 minutes long.
Bully boys blow. Soon may the wellermen come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellermen come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. A drunken sailor, early in the morning, put him in the brig until he's sober, put him in the brig until he's sober, put him in the brig until he's sober, early in the morning, way hey, up she
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, up down, oh, below my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Da 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 da. Before the boat had hit the water, the whale sail came up and caught her. Hands to the side, harp and fought her when she dived down low. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. No line was cut, no whale was freed. The captain's mind was not of greed, and he belonged to the whaleman's creed. She took that ship in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Da 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 da. For 40 days or even more, the line went slack, then tight once more. All boats were lost, there were only four, but still that whale did go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. As far as I've heard, the fight's still on. The line's not cut and the whale's not gone. The wellerman makes his regular call to encourage the captain, crew and all. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Hey!
Our Larkin Mamma can go no further. My old bones ache. Here's a maze trod indeed through forthrights and meanders. By your patience, I must needs rest me.
Oh, the Lord, I cannot blame thee, who am myself attached with weariness to the dulling of my spirits. Sit down and rest you. Even here, I will put off my hope no more for my flatterer. He is gone, whom thus we stray to find. And the sea mocks our frustrate search on land. Well, let him go.
I am right glad that she is so out of hope. Do not, for one repulse, forgo the purpose that you resolve to effect.
The next advantage we will take thoroughly.
Let it be tonight, for they are oppressed with travel. They will not, nor cannot, use such vigilance as when they are fresh.
I say tonight, no more.
What harmony is this? My good friends, hark!
Marvelous sweet music.
Give us kind keepers, heavens, what were these?
A living jewelry. I will now believe there are unicorns that in Arabia there is one tree. The phoenix's throne, one phoenix at the sire reigning there.
I'll believe both. What does else want credit? Come to me and I'll be sworn 'tis true. Travelers ne'er did lie. The fools at home condemned them.
If in Naples I should report this now, would they believe me? If I should say I saw such islanders, for certes these are people of the island, who, though they have monstrous shape yet note, their manner is of more gentle kind than you shall find in our generation many, nay, almost any.
Honest lady, thou hast said well, for some of you there present are worse than devils. Praise in departing.
They vanish strangely.
No matter, since they have left their viands behind, for we have stomachs. Will it please you taste of what's here?
Not I.
Faith, ma'am, you need not fear. When we were young, who would believe that there are mountaineers do laughed like bulls, whose throats had hanging at them wallets of flesh, or that there were such men whose heads stood in their breasts, which now we find each put out of five will bring good warrant of.
I will stand to and feed, although my last, since I feel the best is past. My brother, lord, the duke, stand to and do as we.
You free our man's son, who destiny hath to instrument this lower world, and what is in it? Never the servant sea hath cause to belt you up on this island where man doth not inhabit. You three be most unfit to live. I made you mad! And even with such like valor, men hang and drown their proper selves. You fools! I and my fellows are ministers of fate. You may as well wound the loud winds or kill the steel-closing waters, as much as diminish a dow for my plume. And if you could you hurt, your swords are now too massive for your strength, and will not be uplifted. But remember, for that is my task to thee, that you three did from Milan, so plans could prospero, exposed unto the sea, him and his innocent child, for which foul powers delaying, not forgetting, have incensed all the seas' shores, yea, all the creatures, against your peace. Dear thy son Alonso, they are bereft and to pronounce by me lingering perdition, what any death could be at once, shall step by step attend you and your ways. And nothing shall fall upon your heads but heart sorrow and a clear life ensuing.
Bravely, the figure of this harpy hast thou performed, my Ariel. A grace it had. Devouring of my command, hast thou nothing bated in what thou hast to say? So, with good life and observation strange, my meaner ministers their several kinds have done. My high charms work. These mine enemies are all knit up in their distractions. They are in my power. And in these fits, I leave them. Will I visit young Ferdinand, whom they suppose is drowned? and his and mine loved darling.
In the name of something holy, ma'am, why stand you in this strange stare?
Oh, it is monstrous, monstrous! Methought this billow spoke and told me of it. The winds did sing it to me, and the thunder, that deep and dreadful organ pipe, did pronounce the name of Prosper. It did base my trespass. Therefore, my son in the ooze is bedded, and I'll seek him deeper than air plummet sound, and with him there lie mad!
But one fiend at a time, I'll fight the legions of.
I'll be thy second.
All three of them are desperate. Their great guilt like poison given to work a great time after now gains to bite the spirits. I that am of suppler joints do follow them swiftly and hinder them to what this ecstasy may provoke them to.
If I have too austerely punished you, your compensation makes amends, for I have here given you a third of mine own life, or that for which I live, whom once again I tender to thy hand. All thy vexations were but my trials of thy love, and thou hast, strangely, stood the test here. Afore heaven I ratify this, my rich gift. O Ferdinand, do not smile at me that I boast her off. For thou shalt find she will outstrip all praise and make it halt behind her.
I do believe it against an oracle.
Then is my gift and thine own acquisition worthily purchased. Take my daughter, fairly spoke. Sit then and talk with her. She is thine own. What? Ariel, my industrious servant, Ariel.
Come on, okay, sorry, I gotta go. What would my potent master? Here I am.
Thou and thy meaner fellows your last service did worthily perform, and I must use you in such another trick. Go, bring forth the rabble over whom I give thee power here to this place. Incite them to quick motion, for I must here bestow upon the eyes of this young couple some vanity of mine art.
Presently?
It is my promise, and they expect it of me.
Presently?
Aye, with a twink.
Before you can say, come and go, or breathe twice and cry so-so, each one tripping on his toe, we'll be here with mop and mow. Do you love me, master? No?
Dearly, my delicate Ariel. Do not approach till thou dost hear me call.
Well, I conceive.
Well, now come, my Ariel. Bring a corollary rather than want a spirit. Appear and pert thee. No tongue, all eyes, be silent.
Such amazing visions! Would I be bold to think these spirits?
Spirits, which by mine art I am from their confines called to enact my present fancies.
Wow, let me live here ever, so humble. A loving mother, the wife,
makes this place paradise.
I have forgotten the foul conspiracy of the beast Caliban and his companions against my life. The minute of their plot has almost come. Well done! Avoid! No more!
What is wrong with your mother? She moves in some strange angry.
Never till this day I've seen her so touched with anger and discontent.
You do look, my son, in a moved sort, as if you were dismayed. Be cheerful, sir. Our revels now have ended. These are actors whom I foretold are but spirits, and they are melted into air, into thin air. And the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped towers, the gorgeous palaces, the solemn temples, the great globe itself, ye all which it inherit, shall dissolve. And, like this insubstantial pageant faded, leave not a rack behind. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little lives are rounded with sleep. Sir, I am vexed. Bear with my weakness. My brain is troubled. Be not disturbed by my infirmity. If thou be pleased, retire unto my cell and there repose. A turn or two I'll walk to still my beating mind.
We wish you peace.
Come with a thought. I thank thee, Ariel. Come.
Thy thoughts I cleave to. What's thy pleasure?
Spirit, we must prepare to meet with Caliban.
When I presented the play, I thought to have told thee of it, but feared lest I might anger thee.
Say again, where hast thou left these varlets?
In the filthy mantled pool beyond your cell, dancing up to their chins at the foul lake overstunk their feet.
This is well done, my bird. Thy shape invisible retain thou still. Bring forth the trumpery of my house, for stale to catch these thieves.
I go.
A devil. A born devil, on whose nature can never stick. On whom my pains, humanly taken, all lost. Quite lost. As with age his body uglier grows, so cankers his mind. Oh, I'll plague them all, even to roaring! Come, hang them on this line.
Pray you, tread softly, that the blind mole may not hear a footfall. We are now near her cell.
Oh, monster, this fairy, which you say is a harmless fairy, has done little better than played the jack with us.
Oh, monster, I do smell a horse piss, to which my nose is in great indignation.
So is mine. Do you hear, monster? Or rather, smell? If I should take a displeasure against you...
Thou wert but a lost monster.
Goodbye, king. Give me thy favor still, for the prize I'll lead thee to shall hoodwink this mischance. Therefore, speak softly. All's hushed as midnight yet.
Aye, but to lose our bottles in the pool.
Oh, there is not only disgrace and dishonor in that monster, but an infinite loss. Ah,
was more to me than my wedding. And this be your harmless fairy monster.
I should fetch off my bottle, though I be o'er ears for my labor.
Prithee, my king, be quiet. This here is the mouth of the cell. Go forth and do that good mischief which will make thee king of the isle. For I, Caliban, I, thy foot licker.
No, prithee, give me thy hand. I do begin to have bloody thoughts.
Stefano, oh peer, oh worthy Stefano, Look what a wardrobe is here for thee.
Leave it alone, thou fool. It is but trash.
Oh, ho, monster. We do know it belongs to a frippery.
Drinkulo, put off that gown. By this hand, I'll have that gown.
Thy grace shall have it.
The dropsy drown this fool! What are you to dote on such luggage? Let's alone and do the murder first. For if she awake, she'll fill us from toe to crown with pinches, make us strange stuff.
Be you quiet, monster. Mr. Sline, is this not my jerkin? Now is the jerkin under the line. Now, jerkin, you would like to lose your hair and prove a bald jerkin.
Do, we still by line and level aren't like your grace.
I thank thee for that jest. Here's a garment for it.
Thou art making much ado about nothing!
Wit shall not go unrewarded while I am king of this country. Steel by line and level is an excellent passive paint.
Monster, take some lime upon your fingers and away with the rest.
I shall have none on it. We shall lose our time. And returned to barnacles and apes with foreheads villainous low.
Lay to your fingers, monster. Help me bear this away where my hogshed of wine is, or else I should turn you out of my kingdom. Go to, carry this.
Oh, and this.
Aye. And this.
Silver.
Wow! Sit down!
Oh, Shakespeare!
Cousin Larry, save me!
Mommy, save me!
Thou art vindictive indeed!
Go! Charge my goblins that they grind up their joints with dry convulsions. Shorten up their sinews with age-old cramps. Make them more pitch-spotted than pard or cat of mountain.
Hark! I hear them roar.
Let them be hunted soundly. At this hour lie at my mercy all mine enemies. Shortly shall all my labors end, and thou shalt have the air of freedom. For a little follow, and do me service. Now does my project gather to a head. My charms crack not, my spirits obey. In time goes upright with his carriage. How's the day?
Have the 6 hour, my lord. At which time you said our work should cease.
I did say so, when first I raised the tempest. Say, my spirit, how fares the queen and her followers?
Confined together, all prisoners. They cannot budge till your release. The queen, Sebastian, and Antonio abide, all three distracted, brimful of sorrow and dismay, chiefly her that you term, sir, the good lady Gonzala. Her tears run down her cheeks like winter drops from ease of reeds. If you're to hold them now, your affections would come most tender.
Dost thou think so, spirit?
Mine would, were I human.
And mine shall. Hast thou, which art but air, a touch, a feeling of their afflictions? And shall not myself, one of their kind, that relish all sharply passion as they, be kindlier moved than thou art? Though with their high wrongs I am struck to the quick. Yet my nobler reason gatest my fury. Do I take part? The rarer action is in virtue than in vengeance. They being penitent, the sole drift of my purpose doth extend not a frown further. Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break, their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Ye elves of hills, brooks, standing lakes, and groves, and ye that on the sands with printless foot do chase the ebbing Neptune, and do fly him when he comes back. You demi-puppets,
who by moonshine do the green sour ringlets make, whereof the yew not bites. You whose pastime is to make midnight mushrooms that rejoice to hear the solemn curfew. By whose aid, weak masters though ye be, I have bedimmed the noontide sun, called forth the mutinous winds, betwixt the green sea and the azured vault, set roaring war. To the dread rattling thunder have I given fire, and rifted Jove's stout oak with his own bolt. The strong-based promontory have I made shake, and by the spurs plucked up the pine and cedar. Graves, at my command, have waked their sleepers, oped, and let them forth by my so potent art. But this rough magic I hear abjure, and when I have required some heavenly music, which even now I do, I'll work mine ends upon their senses that this airy charm is for. I'll break my staff, bury it certain fathoms in the earth, and deeper than did ever plummet sound, I'll drown my book. A solemn air, the best comforter, to an unsettled fancy, cure thy brains, now useless, boiled within thy skulls. There stand, for you are spell-stopped. Holy Gonzala, honorable lady, mine eyes even sociable to show of thine fall fellowly drops. The charm dissolves apace, and as the morning steals upon the night, melting the darkness, so their rising senses begin to chase the ignorant fumes that mantle their clearer reason. Oh, good Gonzala, my true preserver, and a loyal lady to her you followest, I'll pay thy graces home, both in word and deed. Most cruelly didst thou, Alonza, use me and my daughter. Thy brother was a furtherer in the act. Thou art pinched for it now, Sebastian. Flesh and blood, you, sister mine, that entertained ambition, expelled remorse and nature, who, with Sebastian, whose inward pinches are most strong, would have here killed your queen. I do forgive thee, unnatural though thou art. Their understanding begins to swell. Not one of them that yet looks on me or would know me, my Ariel. Fetch me the rapier in my cell. I will discase me and myself present as I were sometime Milan. Quickly, spirit, thou shalt ere long be free.
Be sucks, there sucks I. In the cowslip's bell I lie. There I couch where owls do cry. On the bat's back I do fly. After summer merrily, merrily shall I live now. Under the blossom that hangs on the bough.
Why, that's my dainty Ariel. I shall miss thee, though thou shalt have freedom. So. To the queen's ship, invisible as thou art, there shalt thou find the mariners asleep under the hatches. The master and the boatswain, being awake, enforce them here to this place, and presently, I prithee.
Have it here. Some heavenly power guide us out of this country.
Behold, my queen, the wronged Duchess of Milan, Prospero. For more assurance that a living lady does now speak to thee, I embrace thy body, and to thee and thy company I bid a hearty welcome.
If thou beest her, no, or some enchanted trifle to abuse me, as state as I have been, I not know. Thy pulse beats as of flesh and blood. And since I saw thee, the affliction of my mind amends. I fear a madness held me. Thy dukedom I do resign. And do entreat. But thou pardon me my wrongs, but how should Prospero be living and be here?
First, noble friend, let me embrace thine age, whose honor cannot be measured or confined.
Whether this be or be not, I'll not swear.
You do yet taste some subtleties of the isle that will not let you believe things certain. Welcome, my friends, all! But you, my brace of nobles, were I so minded, I could here pluck her highness's frown upon you, justify you traitors. At this time, I will tell no tales.
The devil speaks in her!
No! For you, most wicked ma'am, whom to call sister would infect my mouth, I do forgive thee thy rankest faults, all of them. And require my dukedom of thee, which, perforce, I know thou must restore.
If thou beest her, no. Give us particulars of thy preservation, and how thou hast met us here, who 3 hours since were wrecked upon the shore, where I have lost. Oh, how sharp the point of my remembrance is, my dear son Ferdinand.
Oh, I am woe for it, ma'am.
Irreparable is the loss, and patience says it is past her cure.
I rather think you have not sought her help, by whose soft grace for the like loss I have her sovereign aid, and rest myself content.
You, the like loss?
As great to me as late, and supportable to make the dear loss, have I means much weaker than you may call to comfort you. For I have lost my daughter.
A daughter? Oh, heavens, that they were both living in Naples, the king and queen there! That were they, I wish myself were in that oozy bed where my son lies. When did you lose your daughter?
In this last tempest. I perceive these nobles at this encounter do so much admire that they devour their reason and scarce think their eyes do offices of truth. Their words are natural breath. But howsoever you have been jostled from your senses, know for certain that I am Prospero, and that very duchess which was thrust forth of Milan, who, most strangely, upon this shore, where you were wrecked, was landed to be the lady on it. No more yet of this, for 'tis a chronicle of day by day, not a relation for breakfast, nor befitting this first encounter. Welcome, my queen. This cell's my court. Here have I few attendants and subjects, none abroad. Pray you, look in. My dukedom since you have given me, I will requite you with as good a thing. At least bring forth a wonder to content ye, as much as me, my dukedom.
Sir, you play me false.
Not for the world, my dearest mistress.
For the kingdom of the rings, I would call it fair play.
If this prove a vision of the isle, one dear son shall I twice lose.
A most high miracle.
Although the seas threaten, they are merciful. I've cursed them without reason.
Now all the blessings of a glad mother encompass thee. Arise and say how thou camest here.
Oh, wonder how many goodly creatures there are here. How beauteous mankind is. Oh, brave new world that has such people in it.
'Tis new to thee.
Maid with whom thou wast at play. Your eldest acquaintance cannot be 3 hours. Is she the goddess that had severed us here and brought us thus together?
No, ma'am. She's mortal, but by a mortal province, she is mine. She is the daughter of the famous Duchess of Milan. I've heard so much about these two. Have been like a family to me.
I am hers, but oh, how strange you will sound that I must ask my child forgiveness.
There, my queen, stop. Let us not burthen our remembrance with the heaviness that's gone.
I have inly wept or should have spoke ere this. Look down, you god, and on this couple drop a blessed crown, for it is you that have chalked forth the way that brought us hither.
I say amen, Gonzalo. Now, give me your hands. Let grief and sorrow still embrace his heart that doth not wish you joy.
Be it so, amen. Look, ma'am, look. Here's more of us. I prophesied that if a gallows were on land, this fellow could not drown. Now, bless me, that swears grace o'erboard, but not an oath on shore. Hast thou known about thy land? What is the news?
The best news, we have safely found our queen and company. The next, our ship, which, but 3 glasses since we gave out split, is tight and yea, and bravely rigged when we first put out to sea.
All this have I done since I went.
My tricksy spirit!
These are not natural events. They strengthen from strange to stranger. Say, how came you hither?
If I were honest, ma'am, we were well awake, but I just tried to tell you, my lady. We were dead of sleep, suddenly, and all how we know not clapped under hatches. The wide variety of horrible sounds of roaring, shrieking, jingling of chains and howling, all very horrible in our own respect. Then we were awakened at liberty. And, well, you know, quickly we were. And in her trim, we gazed upon our brave and gallant ship. And upon gazing upon our aforementioned gallant ship, we gazed on our master, keeping a view on her, try so please you, and we were then brought forth moping hither.
This is a strange maze as airmen trod, and more than nature was ever conduct of. Some oracle might rectify our knowledge.
My liege, do not infest your mind with beatings on the strangeness of this business. At picked leisure, which shall be shortly, single, I'll resolve you, which to you shall seem probable, with these happened accidents, till when, be cheerful, and think of each thing well. Come hither, spirit. Set Caliban and his companions free. Untie the spell. How fares, my gracious ma'am? There are yet missing of your company some few odd lads that you remember not. Bring them forth, Ariel.
Oh, let every man shift for all the rest, and let no man take care for himself. Corrigio, bully monster, Corrigio indeed.
If these be true spies which I wear in my head, here's a goodly sight.
Oh, Setebos, these be brave spirits indeed. How fine my master is. I fear she will chastise me.
What are these, my lady Antonia? Will money buy them?
Plain fish, and no doubt marketable.
Mark but the badges of these men, my nobles, then say, if they be true. This misshapen knave, his mother was a witch, and one so powerful that it could control the moon, make ebbs and flows, and deal in her command without her power. These three have robbed me. This demi-devil had plotted with them to take my life. Two of these fellows you must know and own. This thing of darkness, acknowledge mine.
I shall be pinched to death.
Is not this Stefano, my drunken butler?
He is drunk now. Where had he wine?
Oh, and Trigillo is reeling ripe. Say, where is this grand liquor that had gilded them? Say, how camest thou in this pickle?
I have been in such a pickle since I saw thee last. I fear will never out of my bones fear fly blowing.
Why, how now, Stefano?
Oh, touch me not. I am not Stefano, but a cramp.
You'd be king of the island, sirrah?
I should have been a sore one then.
This is as strange a thing as e'er I looked on.
What a thrice doubled ass was I! To
take this drunkard for a god and worship this dull fool! Ah!
Go, Sarah, unto my cell. Take with you your companions, and as you look to have my pardon, trim it handsomely.
Aye. That I will. And hereafter, I'll seek for grace.
I invite your majesty and your train into my poor cell, where in the morn I will bring you to your ship and so to Naples, where I have hoped to see the nuptials of these, our dear beloved, solemnized. Where thence I will retire me to my Milan, where every third thought shall be my grave.
I long to hear the story of your life, which must take to the ear strangely.
I'll deliver all, and promise thee calm seas, auspicious gales, and sails so expeditious that shall catch your royal fleet far off. Ariel, my chick, that is thy charge. Then to the elements, be free. Fare thou well. Please you, draw near. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own, which is most faint. Now, 'tis true, I must be here confined by you, or sent to Naples. Let me not, since I have my dukedom got and pardoned the deceiver, dwell in this fair island by your spell, but release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands. Gentle breath of yours my sails must fill, or else my project fails, which was to please. Now I want spirits to enforce, art to enchant, and my ending is despair. Unless I be relieved by prayer, which pierces so that it assaults mercy itself and frees all faults. As you from crimes would pardon be, let your indulgence set me free.
Thanks everyone for coming. If we could all get your help folding the chairs, that would be great.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of the ship
was the billy O.T. The winds blew harder, bowed it down below, my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellermen come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day...